Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to my channel. Students, in the previous class, we have discussed types of queues, applications of queues, what are the methods we are used to represent the queue in the memory, and DQ and NQ operations, algorithms, right? So, queue and stack concept can be implemented using array data structure. Array is a linear data structure. By using the array data structure, we are implementing the queue and stack concept. So, that array is having one disadvantage. What is the disadvantage of array? See here, arrays are static structure. Arrays are static structure. Static means fixed. Once the size is fixed at the implementation of the program, so we want to increase the size of the array, it is not possible. We want to decrease the size of the array, it is not possible. So, that nature we are called as a static nature. Array is a static structure. It means once the size is fixed in the memory, it does not extend the memory and it does not reduce the compressed memory. Clear? So, in this array, the insertion and deletion operations, it is difficult to perform because consider, I will write one array. Of size is 6. So here we are inserting the element 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. The positions I will written as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is one dimensional array. The size of the array is 5. Sorry, the size of the array is 6. Here I will store 6 elements to the array. The 6 elements I will take as 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 and 60. Right, clear? So, I want to insert the element 15. I want to insert the element 15. What happens? In which position we want to insert? We have mentioned the position, right? So, I will mention the position 1. We are inserting the new element 15 at which position? At the position 1. So what we have to do for inserting the new element to this array, to this existing array? So we are shifting the position 1 to next elements to the higher order position. How we are perform the shifting operation? First, the last element is shifted to the next position. This position is vacant. Next, this element we are shifted to this position. Now this position is vacant. We are shifting 40 to the next position and vacant this position. We are shifting 30 from this position to this position and away. We are vacant this position. Later we are shifting 20 from position 1 to position 2. Now the required position 1 becomes empty. We can insert the new element to the array. And later, we are increase the size of the array by 1 unit, then array size is 7. See here, the size of the array we are given is 6. We are inserting only one element in the position 1. How many shifts can be takes place here? 1 shift, 2 shift, 3 shift, 4 shift, 5 shifts. Suppose if the array is having 100 elements, we want to insert the element in the first portion, how many shifts can be takes place? Totally it will take 99 shifts, right? So, once all the elements can be shifted to the higher positions, then only we are inserting. It is difficult because it will take more processing time to perform the insertion operation. Clear? Like that, we want to remove the element from the queue. What happens? Suppose I will remove the element 15 from the queue. So here, sorry, from the array, here we know array does not give any blank space between two numbers. Because array elements can be stored by using a contiguous memory locations. So that's why after removing one element from the array, we have shift the next element to the previous position or lower order position. After that, 30 will be shifted to lower order position. Later, 40 will be shifted to lower order position. Later, 50 will be shifted to lower order position. Later, 60 will be shifted to lower order position. Later, we are decreasing n size by 1 unit. Your elements are less, it will take 5 shifts. If the elements are more, it will take more shifts, right? Again, the deletion operation is also difficult in the static structure. Array is a static structure. Once the size is fixed, the size is, it cannot be extended and the memory size cannot be reduced. So, this insertion and deletion operations in the array, it is a tedious task to perform when the array contains more numbers. Clear? So, to overcome this disadvantage, namigili a disadvantage idiyo, even the disadvantage na overcome madodike antane, to avoid the drawback of the array, we are using another new concept is dynamic memory allocation. So, this dynamic memory allocation can be done by using the new data type called linked list. To overcome the drawback of the array concept, we are used dynamic memory allocation. This dynamic memory allocation can be done with the help of the data structure linked list. Clear? To overcome the drawback of the array, we are used dynamic memory allocation. That dynamic memory allocation can be done with the help of linked list data structure. Then what is linked list? How to define linked list data structure? So you all will give the definition. Linked list is a linear data structure. Linked list is a linear data structure. It is a linear collection of data elements. It is a linear collection of data elements called nodes. Linear collection of data elements called nodes. And the linear order is given by a pointer. So linked list definition one mark is very important. ಇದು ಯಾವ ತರ ಲಿಂಕ್ಡ್ ಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಮಾಡಿದೀವಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ನೋಡು ಸರಿ ಸೊ ಲಿಂಕ್ಡ್ ಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಲೀನಿಯರ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಕಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೀನಿಯರ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ನೋಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಲೀನಿಯರ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಈಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಬೈ ಪಾಯಿಂಟರ್ ಸೊ ಯೋ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಡೈಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲಿಂಕ್ಡ್ ಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ನೋ ದ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ನೋಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನೋಡ್ ನೋಡ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಲಿಂಕ್ ಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ನೋಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ಸ್ ಟೂ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ ನೋಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ಸ್ ಟೂ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಟೂ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ called as data field. The second field called as address field. This data field we are also called as information field. In short form we are called info. The first field of the linked node is called as the data field. This data field we are also called as information field. In short form we call as the info field. The second field called as the address field. This address field we are also called as link field. Clear? Node is a structure. So this is a node. This node is having two fields. The node is having two fields. This is first field, this is second field. The first field we are called as a data field. The data field we are also called as information field or info field. The second field of this node called as address field. The address field we are also called as link field. Clear? Node ki artha maadkoli channel. Node andre structure. Node is a structure. It contains two fields. The first field called as a data field. The second field of the node called as a link field. So, in this data field, the data field can be used to store the data. The data field can be used to store the data. The data is either any type. Either it is an integer type, character type, double type or floating point value. Clear? So this data field we are declared by using basic data types. The data field used to store the data. The data is of any type. The data field declared with basic data types. Basic data types such as, what are the basic data types? Int, float, char, double, etc. Clear? The data field can be declared by using any of the basic data because it will use to store the data. The data is either integer, character, or floating point value. Next, the link field. The link field contains only the address. The link field contains only the address. That address is another node address. So this link field always declared as a pointer variable. Link field we are taken as a pointer variable because you know the definition of pointer variable. It is a variable. It holds the address of another variable. We know the address of another variable using this link field. So that's why this field we are declared as a pointer variable. Clear? Node andre gottaita? Node is a structure. It is having two fields. The first field called information field or data field. This field used to store the data of any type. This field we are declared by using any of the basic data types such as int, float, char, double, etc. The second field of this node we are called as the address field. Address field we are also called as the link field. So this field used to know the address of the next node. So that's why this field we are declared as a pointer variable. Clear? So linked list means it is a collection of linear data elements called nodes. It means it is a collection of nodes. See, first node, second node, third node, fourth node. Four nodes we are taken. In the first node, data field stored 10. Second node, data field contains 20. Third node, data field contains 30. Fourth node, data field contains 40. We are takes the second node address using first node address field. Takes the third node address by using second node address field. Takes the fourth node address by using third node address field. There is no another node. That's why here we have stored the null value. It will indicate the end of the linked list. And the first node address we are taken using a pointer variable called stored. Stored always stores the address of the first node. This is the definition of linked list. Idu linked list ke definition. Iga heli definition na linked list is a linear data structure. Linear data structure in that it contains homogeneous elements. See here, all the elements are integer type only. It is a linear collection of data elements called nodes. Linear collection of data elements called nodes. Four nodes. Then the linear order is given by pointer. See, linear order. The first node stores here. The second node stores here. Third node stores here. Fourth node stores here. The linear order can be given by pointer. Pointer means the link field. This is the definition of linked list. Clear? After the definition of the node and the definition of the linked list, we want to know how to declare a node in the program. How to declare a node in the program. What is the definition of node? Node is a structure, right? By using structure definition, we are declaring the node. So you know the structure definition. Struct keyword can be used to define the structure. Here, which structure we are created? Node structure. That's why the structure name I will given has node. The node structure we are declared by using the struct keyword. The node is having two fields, right? The first field we are called as the data field. Data field can be declared by using any of the data type. Here I have taken integer data. And the second field is a link field. So this link field is a pointer variable. Can be declared by using the structure name node. And the structure definition closing flower bracket, terminate using semicolon. Yeah. So see here, this is the definition syntax of the node. Take a definition. Node is a structure. It contains two fields. The first field we are called as a data field. It is used to store the data values or information. It can be declared by using any of the basic data. The second field we are called as a address field or link field that holds the address of another node. That's why it is taken as a pointer variable. The pointer variable can be declared by using a structure name. The structure name is node. Yeah. So the fields of structure can be declared inside the pair of flower brackets and terminates with semicolon. Artha aitala? So this is the way to declare the structure node. Then we go for the next concept. How to initialize value to the node? How to initialize values to the node? So once we write this code in the memory, it will create one structure. Memory only one structure create agutte. A structure ge one name anna tagolutha adu node anta. Yakandre a structure name anta tagolutha node anta kodidivi alva. Andre memory alli namge one node create aayitu. Aa node alli two fields aagide. Ee node ge naavu node antane name hesaru kodidive. First field anna integer inta declare madidive. Hagagi integer value na store maadbekagutte. Second field to address field. ಆದರೆ ಅಡ್ರೆಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡೋಕೆ ಬೇರೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ನೋಡ್ ಅನ್ನು ನಾವು ತಗೊಂಡಿಲ್ಲ, ಒಂದೇ ನೋಡ್ ಅನ್ನು ಮಾತ್ರ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಈ ಒಂದು ಅಡ್ರೆಸ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನನ್ನ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂನ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೀ ನನ್ನ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್, ಈ ಒಂದು ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ನೋಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಇಂಟೀಜರ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ನ ಅಡ್ರೆಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಲ್ ಅಂತ. ಹೌ ವಿ ಆರ್ ರೈಟ್ ಅಸೈನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಯಾವ ತರ ಅಸೈನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಬರೀತೀವಿ ಈ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂನ ಈ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಗೆ, ಈ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂನ ಈ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಗೆ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲೈಸ್ ಮಾಡೋಕೆ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ನೇಮ್ ನೋಡ್. Arrow symbol, it is a membership operator. This field we are called as a data field. Node of data field, we are stored the value is still. See, the data field we are created in the structure named node. This field is a data field. For this field, we are stored value 10. By using the statement node of data field contains value 10. Then how to assign null value for this field? Structure name, membership operator, and no field name, link field, we have field null value. These two are the assignment statements we are used to initialize value to the data fields and address field in the node structure. Clear students? The definition of the node is clear, and how to define the node in the program, how to initialize value to the node. Clear? So next we go for the diagram linked list. The diagrammatic representation of a linked list. Here I will write one diagram and explain. We are using one pointer variable called start. It is always used to store the address of the first node. This is the first node in the linked list. It will contain the value 10. Then we have stored the second node address in the first field, address field. In the second node data field contains the value 20. The second node address field contains the address of third node, and third node contains value 30. It will contain the address of the fourth node. The fourth node contains the value is 40, and that is the last node. Students, this is a diagrammatic representation of the linked list. In this diagram, the linked list contains how many nodes? Four nodes. See, one node, two node, this is third node, and this is the fourth node. The linked list contains totally four nodes. All four nodes is having only two fields. The first field of each node is the data field. The second field of the each node is the address field. Clear? So in the data field we have stored linear data elements. Linear data elements means similar homogeneous data elements. See, 10, 20, 30, 40. All are integer type only. The nodes we are arranged in linear order. So, namge train node idiralva. Train alli pratiyondu compartment anna yav tara arrange maadirtare. One after the other arrange maadirtare. Join maadirtare. Right? Like that. In the linked list, each and every node we are arranged one after the other. So, these nodes will be arranged in the linear order by using the address field. The first node address field contains the address of second node. The second node address field contains the address of third node. The third node address field contains the address of the fourth node. The fourth node address field contains null. Which node address field contains null? That node is the last node in linked list. Then, which node address we have received from start point variable? That node we call as the first node. The first node address always we have stored is in the start. It is a pointer variable, it holds the address of first node. Clear? So, this is about diagrammatic representation of linked list. Next concept is types of linked list. The linked list is classified into three types. They are number one, singly linked list. LL stands for linked list. Number two, doubly linked list. Number three, circularly linked list. Circularly linked list. Single, singly, double, doubly, circular, circularly linked list. There are three types of linked list are available. They are singly linked list, doubly linked list, and circularly linked list. So, almost all algorithms we are implemented by using only singly linked constant. We are discussed in the next class. Thank you.